What's up, team? As always, I hope you're having a fantastic day. I always love to watch the new Apple events where they release the new iPhones. However, it seems like the last past few years, we didn't get any major big upgrades. And this year is no exception with the iPhone 16 Pro. However, I still upgraded and I'll let you know why. First, let's unbox this beautiful thing. As you can see, I went with the natural titanium color and I really, really like it. It's sort of a warm silver and I think it just fits my vibe really well. I like that it's kind of a neutral tone and it's also a bit different from the black that I usually go with. Now, in terms of design, there are a few changes from the 15 Pro and the only major one is the addition of the new camera button, which we'll come back to in a second. However, there are still some other minor changes. For example, the bezels are now slimmer, the screen is a little bit larger. Honestly, if you're putting a 15 and a 16 Pro one next to the other, you won't really see the differences right away. However, as you start to look, you'll see that there are subtle changes. Now, another upgrade that Apple mentioned is that the new iPhones are supposed to be a lot more resistant, which means they're not as likely to get scratches, for example. However, even though I think it looks great without a case, I'm not going to risk it. And in fact, Polaroid just sent me their new phone cases for the iPhone 16 Pro. So we're gonna install it and look at how it looks. When it comes to picking a case for my phone, I have a list of criteria. The first one is it has to be ultra slim. I don't like to have bulky cases. And then since I'm a designer as my work, I also like to have beautifully designed products. And I think this Belvoir case meets all of those expectations. Belvoir is a B certified corporation. This means that they pay close attention to the impact they have on the environment. And as a matter of fact, you can see that the leather on this case was eco tanned, which I think is pretty cool. As you can see, I went with the Sienna case for the leather color, and I think it matches the color of the natural titanium super, super well. In fact, it kind of reminds me of the classic Porsches that were, you know, silver in the exterior and had that tan leather interior. I think this looks really, really cool. As I mentioned in the beginning of this video, the new iPhone 16 Pro doesn't come with any major upgrades. In fact, we got just pretty small incremental changes. However, there are still a few reasons why I upgraded. In fact, there's exactly four. The first one is that this is the first iPhone to ever be built especially for Apple Intelligence. It also comes with upgraded cameras as well as the new camera button, which we'll talk about pretty soon. The iPhone 16 and 16 Pro also has better battery life, which I have tested and I'll talk about that pretty soon as well. And then the fourth reason, if I'm being completely honest, I'm trying to make more tech related content here on YouTube and I just thought it would be exciting to showcase the new iPhone, so that's the fourth reason. The best way to talk about cameras is to show their performance, and I thought a coffee video would be the perfect fit. So just check this out and let me know if you think that you see a difference. And now, of course, if we're talking about cameras, we need to talk about the elephant in the room. It is the new camera control button. This is supposed to act sort of like a real camera, and a lot of people have said it is placed in a bit of an awkward spot. And I totally agree, especially if you're holding your phone in a portrait mode. And in fact, I thought this was gonna be a feature that I wouldn't use at all in the beginning, and I would kind of get used to using it and then use it more and more. However, the exact opposite kind of ended up happening. In the beginning, I was using it way more because I was excited to test out this new feature, then I started to use it less and less. The goal of this was to make it feel a bit more like a real camera. And if you've seen any of my everyday carry or backpack videos, you'll know that I always carry my camera, the one I'm filming my videos with right now. And that hasn't really changed. I still love the feeling of a real camera. There's something different, even just the lens. You can see the nice like blurred background and stuff. That doesn't really happen with this camera from what I've tested right now. The main reason is just because it still lacks full customizability. You can't like play around with shutter speed and stuff like that, for example. But that being said, the new cameras are still really good. I was pretty impressed at how much you could zoom into the pictures without really losing any qualities. And even though I don't use the camera button that often, I still use it every now and then. And I'm gonna have to agree with almost every other creators out there. that the camera button is a bit awkward to use at first. However, you get used to it really, really quickly. And then you can kind of develop your own sort of reflexes with it and it becomes a pretty useful tool. But I still prefer to use the regular kind of buttons that are on the screen. It's easier to reach. However, that is different if I'm using my phone in a landscape mode. When I'm using it in landscape mode, the button is at the right place. It feels pretty natural to use it there. It feels almost like a camera. And I'm really looking forward to see what they're gonna do in the future with this type of buttons, since it is really cool to see that you still get the kind of half press feeling. You get, you know, different actions if you double click it, if you full press on it, stuff like that. I think this is a really cool technology that they could use a lot more and get more juice out of it. An example would be for the action button on the side. Maybe they could make that into the same kind of button that they use for the camera button, and then we could get a lot more options out of it. Now, when it comes to battery life, Apple didn't really mention anything specific on there, so I really had to test it myself. So what I did is I just brought my phone with me for a whole day without really charging it. Every day sort of starts the same. I wake up at around 6 a.m., pick up my phone to see how my sleep was, and I always noticed that my phone had better sleep than me. It's always recharged at 100%. And then I just moved on with my day. I like to watch videos during the morning when I'm cooking up breakfast, or if I'm at the gym, for example, I'll listen to podcasts, stuff like that. And I'll continue to do that throughout the morning while I am working. I usually like to take a small break at lunch to watch more videos if I'm alone. Otherwise, I'll be like talking with my friends. However, most of the days were pretty much the same. My battery was still at around 70-ish% at 1 p.m., which is pretty good. And by the end of the day, it was usually around the 50% mark, since I don't use it too much in the afternoon. Now, this means I could technically use it for pretty much 2 days straight. However, that's not really been the case. I've tried to do that and it usually dies in the second day in the afternoon. Now, because I'm doing this video a bit later than most other creators, I have a bit more insights to share with you. For example, Marcus Brownlee did a test and he showed that the iPhone 16 Pro had a 9% larger battery than the 15 Pro. Which might not sound too big, however, when you consider that they now last so long, 9% does do a pretty big difference. Now, another big point for the iPhone 16 is that it is the first iPhone to be built specifically for Apple Intelligence. Now, for that, you get the new A18 Bionic chip, which comes with a 6-core GPU, 6-core CPU, and also 8 gigs of RAM. You also get, as mentioned, the improved battery life. However, Apple Intelligence hasn't rolled out yet, so it's a bit of a bittersweet feeling. You're buying a phone for this like cool new feature, but it's not out yet. However, it should be rolling out by early December. Now, I am running a beta software on my phone that includes Apple Intelligence, and I will make a deep dive into this specific feature. If that's something you like, just let me know down in the comments below.
Hey Siri, how are you doing today?
A few of the cool features I'd like to share with you right now are, first, the new Siri animation, which looks really cool. It now has like a full screen animation with color and stuff. So it looks very, very AI. For some reason, the AI trend is to put colors, purple, ingredients everywhere, and they've done that fantastically. Another really cool feature that I like about Apple Intelligence is that it will get all of your notifications and do kind of a recap with AI, and it does that really, really well. You're also able to turn your voice notes into transcription, so to get a text afterwards. And this works really well if you're speaking English. However, I've tried this with my colleagues that are French and it really, really doesn't work well at all. Maybe it's just because my phone is in English and if it were set in French, it would work, but we had a few funny moments with this. Now, when it comes to the big question of should you be upgrading to the 16 Pro, it really depends on you. Of course, pricing is gonna play a big role in this question. The price of these phones are really, really high, and you can pick up a 15 or 15 Pro for a bit cheaper, and you still get Apple Intelligence, which I think is really the game changer. Yes, this phone has slightly better cameras, and you get the cool camera button, but I don't think it's a game changer. I'll personally upgrade if you're anything under a 13 or 13 Pro to the 15 or 16, and then it'll be your choice to see if you think that the camera button is really worth the extra price for the brand new 16 lineup. That's it for today. I hope you enjoyed the video, and remember to like and subscribe as it really helps me to make more content for you guys. I'll see you all in the next one. Have a nice day.